Hey, I'm Lazar, and I want to show you how Sentry can help you identify and debug slow database queries in your application. We're going to set up a workflow that includes monitoring for database queries, setting up alerts so we get an email or Slack notification every time a database query takes more than 1 second, for example, and we're also going to build a dashboard that will help us keep an eye on all of the database queries across our projects. This is going to be a Laravel application, but bear in mind that Sentry's database query monitoring works in virtually any framework or technology. So, without further ado, let's dive in. This is the app that I mentioned. It's a habit tracking application that lets us add habits and also generate a bunch of test data because, again, it's a demo application. But the slow database query happens when we go to the reports page. So look how long it takes for that page to load. Way too long. Let's go in Sentry. We'll head to Insights and we'll click on our Laravel project. If you don't see your Laravel project here, you can always go to the backend page and look for your project. Sentry is smart enough to recognize that this is a Laravel project, so for our backend overview page, it renders a Laravel specific overview page. For example, we have all of our requests here, an average and P95 of the span durations in this widget, all of the issues that have been happening in our application, background jobs if we have any, slow database queries, cache miss rates, and also all of the endpoints that are registered along with their methods and even where they are in the project. So on this page, we can see multiple indicators that something is wrong with our project. First, we can see that the P95 and even the average span duration spike and go way after 1 second. The slow queries also show us that there are some spikes here that we need to look into. And even the endpoints table show us that the reports page actually takes the most time to load. So looking at this, we know that there's something wrong in the reports page and that it's most likely the slow database query. But let's actually confirm that. If we click on the slowest database query here, first we'll see the raw SQL that gets executed against the database. We'll see that it's in the reports controller.php in the index function. If we scroll down, we can actually see that this is indeed in the get/reports page. If we click on it, we'll get a little slide out that gives us all of the spans that have been captured. Based on the duration and the compared to average columns, we can figure out which one we want to look into. So let's just pick out this one, for example. Once we click that, we're going to be taken to the trace view. And this gives us an overview of how the page loaded when the user tried to load it. So we have the page load at the top. We have the browser cache connect DNS. Then the request happens on /reports, as we can see here. And now this is what happened on the backend. Here's that slow database query because it takes 1.52. We can also see what happens after our server responded back and React took over. Looking at the web vitals, we can see that the time to first byte is poor, the first pane is poor, the FCP, LCP, and basically they're all red. In order to debug this further, we already have all of the information, right? We have the actual query that doesn't really look like this, but we have the location. It's in the report controller on line 69. So we can go in, take a look at the query, fix it, push a new fix to production, and wait for it to be resolved. But to make sure that we actually fixed this issue, we need to set up an alert, because if it regresses, we want to get notified on it. So let me show you how you can do that. First, we'll go to the Explore page and make sure that you're on the traces. This is our Trace Explorer. It basically gives us a way to filter out all of the spans and compare them, create alerts or dashboard widgets. So that's what exactly what we're going to do. In the filter above, we're going to do span.op for operation. And this is going to be a db.sql.query. Because we have our filter set to all projects, let's just make sure that our project is our Laravel project, and we can hit enter. Now we see a list of all of the database spans that are captured and belong to our Laravel project. In order to visualize this better, I'm going to click on the P95 and I'm also going to set the time range to the last 24 hours. There we go. So P95 in the last 24 hours, 1.39, 1.38. Yep, this looks correct. And in order to create an alert on this, we're going to click on the Save As, Add an Alert for P95. There we go, this is the Create Alert page or New Alert page. We see a chart at the top. This basically mirrors what the filter does. So we want to define the metric as a P95 based on the duration. And it's important to set the thresholds. It's critical if it's above 1 second. And we want to get a warning if it's above 500 milliseconds or half a second. Once we punch these values in, we can see that we have these two areas at the top, and this basically gives us an overview of thresholds, if we are hitting those thresholds or not. For example, if we change this to 750, we're going to see the yellow or the warning threshold go up a little bit. Okay, so let's say that we're happy with the thresholds. We want to set an action. So for critical, we want to email myself. And also for warning, we want to send a Slack notification and tag me in Slack. All right. We're going to add a SlowDB query name as the alert name, and we can keep the group as the ownership. All right. So I'm going to save this rule. There we go. Now it's created. So now every time a database query, doesn't matter which one, takes more than 1 second, I'm gonna get an email, or if it takes more than 500 milliseconds, I'm gonna get slacked. And here's how that email shows like. I'm gonna show a screenshot of the warning and also on the critical emails that we receive. All right, so that was the alerts. I'm gonna show you how you can do the same, but instead of alerts, we're actually going to create a database widget. So back to the trace view. Span operation is DB SQL query. The project is Laravel Slow Database. We're gonna do P95 on the duration, and instead of saving it as an alert, we wanna save it as a dashboard widget. We're going to select which dashboard we wanna add it to, or create a new one if we don't have one. I'm just gonna add it to the backend overview dashboard. Proceed, and we can customize the widget now. For example, for this case, I want an area instead of bar. This looks correct, P95 on the duration, the filter is automatically inherited. And yeah, at the end, we're just going to name our widget something like database queries, and I'm going to hit add widget. All right, there we go. So this at the top is my old database queries, but the new one is usually at the bottom, and you can always go and edit the dashboard and bring it up or resize it if you want. But yeah, this basically lets you create a dashboard, add your database queries here, and you can keep an eye on all of your database queries. What's cool about the widgets is that they also follow along the project environments and time range that we set here. For example, if I set this to the last hour, the widget will automatically be refreshed. That's about it. From this point on, we'll get an email if another database query or this one regresses. Takes more than 1 second, or gets slacked, or we can just always come by and look at our dashboards to see how the overall database queries perform in our project. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.